And then I'll be talking a little bit about some of the more difficult issues we face in the environment, in particular the problem of plastic. So I hope you'll join me for some of those talks. If you see me around the ship and you see something flying around, you don't know what it is, please, please just come and ask me, and I'll try and help you with identifying things when we're out on deck as well. Thank you.
Thank you. this little town, Åndalsnes, is the end station of a railway, you see. It has developed as the end station of the railway. And there is a very special building here, the one you see here on the right-hand side. It's not a modern church. Before they got the railway line here, there were only two farms. And one was called Åndal and the other was called Nes. And when they got the train station here, they called the train station Åndalsnes. So that's when it started to develop here, and that was in 1924, as the time when they got the railway station. Two mountain roads, each of them with 11 hairpin curves, very steep, but you shouldn't be afraid. Shouldn't be anxious. We have and where the bridge is behind us now, that's where the river is flowing into the big Romstad fjord. And the Romstad horn. You see it now on the left-hand side. But when Carl Hall from Denmark got up there and they or small, what we call hanging valleys, high up in the mountains. And if there is a waterfall coming out from a little hanging valley, you can be quite sure there is a little lake up there. The small waterfalls coming from melting snow dry out, of course, but never the big ones. There are two walking lanes if you want to take a walk out to the viewpoints. You can do so, but it's entirely up to you if you want to walk or not. There is a cafe, there is a souvenir shop, and there are restrooms, and you can take a flat walk out to the closest viewpoint. It's a little longer out to the other viewpoint. A little steep and also some steps, so it's entirely up to you how far you want. Look out here now to the left, yeah.
That's as good as anything in your
cemetery. And that can take some time. The people that park the car here, they go hiking. It's also a very nice hiking area. And it's also very popular for skiing. This road is closed in the winter, but when they open it at the end of May, lots of people go up here for skiing. Oh, look at the sheep.
Oh my.
Oh yeah, they're down here.
They go grazing up here all summer. This is the highest point, 852 meters to be exact. And look at these close to the road to the left. And partly also with coal. Look at this short bridge. Very narrow. It's from 1924, built at a time when no one was thinking about tourist buses to pass through. are down there, little guy in your village. There is one cruise ship, I think.
Cruise ship?
I think it's one of the Italian Costa ships. Sometimes there are three and four cruise ships at the same time. To the right, far out there in the fjord, you can see the waterfalls that we call the Seven Sisters. But from here, you can only see two or three. And if you pass out there, a few of them along the fjord, but they are all abandoned. But people lived there until the 1950s, even to the 60s, but without the road and without electricity. They had a very steep path. They had to descend and ascend from the boathouse to the farm. And they took everyone who's got a suitable piece of land and now build camping sites or cabins for rent. And there are altogether four hotels, but just one is open the whole year. And that's the hotel that we will go to for lunch. It's a very good hotel. Here in front of us on the left-hand side of the fjord, you see a mountain edge just in the bend to the left, and that's called the pulpit. That's the pulpit in the Geiranger fjord, about 400 meters high. And there is also a path from the village along the steep mountainside out to the pulpit, and down on the other side to a now abandoned mountain farm. It's about 4 hours hike. So this is the little village center of Geiranger, with souvenir shops, a few small cafes, kiosks, and that's all.
Thank you. back a little bit. Thank you. see it.